This demonstration here is a little bit more exciting version of the flame test lab or demo that is normally done. And what I'm doing here, I'm pouring methyl alcohol across several different well plates containing different metal salts, and what my students call a bartending look here. But what I've done, poured the alcohol across all the salts, and what I'd like, just one, all the others catch on fire there real quick. We can see there, as they have caught on fire, that we have several different colored of flames, including down on the end, just the blue flame of the alcohol burning. Next is the barium salt burning there. The next one there, a little hard to see, is a green color. That is boron. The next one is strontium. The next one in line looks like it is the calcium to me, the orange flame there. Next one, fairly faint, a lot of impurities in that one, but that is lithium. It's the pink color that you see. The next one is a yellow flame. That is sodium, followed by copper, which is burning green, and potassium, which is burning purple or lilac. And so a beautiful demonstration, of course, although an awesome demonstration, a lot of different applications for these, including signal flares, including fireworks. As I've mentioned previously, this demonstration or this process has been used to identify a lot of previously unknown elements. A lot of previously unknown elements were identified first by flame test or spectral analysis of those elements. There's also some mini entertainment versions of this, including just tossing metals into a campfire or buying fireplace crystals for your home fireplace to see these beautiful colors. Also, Hollywood used to use these for colored flames, although nowadays they tend to use special effects and computer generation rather than actual metal salts to produce beautiful colors.